just factored down our last two terms out of this quadratic. However, let's look at, so we tried to factor this 2x squared minus 7x plus 6, and we said it has these two factors right here. So if I multiply the two factors, I'm not going to get back up to my original polynomial. So I'm going to write that 2x squared minus 7x plus 6. So these are not quite equal. There is a missing factor on the right side. What is the additional factor I need for these to be equal? And it's a 2. Now, why is that? You can FOIL these out right here, and you'll figure out pretty quickly you have half of what you need. The reason is, it's definitely true that factors correspond to zeros. However, this 2, I'm going to reorder this and then multiply the 2 into that second term. So it's pretty easy to do that. You get 2x minus 3. So I want you to go ahead and FOIL out these two right now. So FOIL these out. And you should see that you get back to 2x squared minus 7x plus 6. So zeros do correspond to factors, but there can be a constant factor that doesn't show up as a zero. So each zero will correspond to a factor depending on how you write it. You can see it represented like this, just x minus that number, that's a zero. But if it's not an integer, if you write it like that, there'll also be an integer factor out front as well, or a constant factor out front. Yes, sir.
So yesterday when we wrote down, I don't know where it was, but we wrote down the x minus 2 and x minus 3 halves when we were finding the zeros.
Yep.
Yeah, right. Yeah, right.
So those two are factors.
Yeah. Why didn't we just skip the process of having to distribute that 2? Why didn't we just realize that it would have been 2x minus 3? Because?
Well, you can write it either way.
Okay.
So what I'm showing here is you can consider this together, like distribute the 2 or not distribute the 2. And you should be able to see it either way.
Okay.
No matter what, when x equals 3 halves, this entire term becomes 0.
Okay.
In either this form that I put a box around or the distributed form down there. So either way, when you plug in the 0, the x value that makes it 0, you'll turn this factor into 0.
Okay.
All right, so the original problem, I think, said write down all zeros somewhere. What question were we doing? Factor. No. I have to go up even higher. There's a lot of work on this problem. Oh, I did way more than write down all possible zeros. All right, so we wrote down all possible zeros right here. And I'm just going to summarize all zeros. So if I write down all zeros, we have x equals negative 1, 2/3. Is that right? Negative 1, 3 halves, and 2. So there's all zeros written out. So we just took this polynomial and figured out all zeros. We know zeros correspond to x-intercepts. So you can graph this polynomial as well. So that's what I want you to do right now. What do we need to graph? half, we need x-intercepts. I need to know cross bounce, which ones cross, which ones bounce. Some of these cross, some of these bounce. So I want you to figure out which are crossing, which are bouncing. The other thing we need for graphing is end behavior. So you're looking at the leading term. Good news is the leading term is pretty easy to see in this polynomial because I gave it to you in the expanded form, not in the factored form. So all you have to do is just look at the high power term. So the end behavior, this is going to behave like y equals 2x to the fourth. So we got a positive coefficient, even exponent. So what does that look like with the cloud? Positive coefficient, even exponent. So figure out crossing or bouncing on your zeros. And then the end behavior, and then take that information and create your graph. And I'll give you 2 minutes for this.
What equation do we look at to determine the cross or bounce?
The order of the factors, how many times the factor appears.
Oh, okay.
What's the number once? So I just wrote the factored form up, so you can see even odd factors if they're order one or order two for crossing and bouncing.